Breaking: entire Indiana Police Department quits after being told to do these three sick things. Unfortunately, liberalism has so infected our culture that disregard for our police officers is now widespread. Those who most deserve our respect, the men and women who put themselves in harm's way to keep us safe, are constantly hindered from doing their job properly. That's being seen in a shocking new case unfolding in Bunker Hill, Miami County, Indiana, where the entire police force has resigned because the town council repeatedly asked them to perform illegal, unethical, and immoral activities. Michael Thomason, who has served as town marshal for the last 4 years, is leading the resignation of himself and four volunteer reserve officers. Thomason and his team had been considering resignation for months after being subject to ongoing harassment and intimidation from the local politicians. One of the main charges against the Bunker Hill Town Council is that they wanted to use the police to collect information on their political rivals. The police officers refused to take part in unethical abuses of their resources. The resignation letter presented by the former officers states that members of the town council continuously requested background checks on fellow councilors. They wanted to uncover their criminal history. Thomason states that when he and his team did not comply with the illegal orders, they were threatened. The local police found themselves in a situation of choosing between morality and their livelihood. The resigned officers also resigned because the town failed to provide them with the funding and equipment necessary to face the dangers of their job. There was not enough quality body armor to go around, putting the policemen's lives at risk when out on the streets. Thomason said, "I did not want to send someone out there with bad body armor, so I would take mine off and provide it to the other officers. I told them we have to provide this. There is an IC code that explains that and says that the town has to provide that body armor." For Thomason, there were also personal reasons relating to his resignation. He took time off after being diagnosed with cancer. But after he was prepared to return to work, the city would only give him part-time work. The city was playing with an officer's career as an intimidation game to cajole him into getting in line with their demands. Bunker Hill residents are feeling the loss of their police force. The police provide an invaluable service. Local families no longer feel safe without them. For the moment, the town is receiving protection from the county sheriff's office while they work on hiring a new group of police. However, many officers who have been contacted are familiar with the situation and have refused the job. As expected, the town council denies that it's been involved in any wrongdoing. They assert that the differences between them and the police department had nothing to do with illegal requests or with lack of body armor. Via Fox 59. It's frustrating that when money is wasted on causes that shouldn't be receiving public funding like illegal aliens and refugees, there's seemingly nothing left over for the folks who go so far as giving their lives to protect American families. Just as angering is the thought that corrupt politicians see police as nothing more than pawns to use for their immoral plans, rather than the heroes they really are.